In this video, we're going to take a closer look at the oscilloscope, and we're going to take some measurements of an actual circuit here. This circuit right here is a battery-powered circuit that outputs a time-varying signal. We're going to be measuring it with three different oscilloscopes so we can become familiar with the common features on all oscilloscopes. We have a new digital oscilloscope here. We've got a slightly older oscilloscope here, and then we've got a very old oscilloscope down here. We're going to take some measurements of this circuit using all three of these oscilloscopes, but before we get started, let's first take a look at some of the features common to all oscilloscopes. Of course, the first important button on an oscilloscope is the power button. We'll need to turn it on. Let's assume that this little circuit diagram down here to the right represents the circuit that we want to measure. At the top of the resistor, we want to know what that signal looks like, and we want that to display on the screen. Keep in mind that the function of an oscilloscope is to just draw the voltage with respect to time and sweep over and over again. Different models of oscilloscopes have different numbers of channels available for drawing signals. All three of the oscilloscopes that we're going to be looking at today have two channels available. We're only going to be using one of those channels, but keep in mind that sometimes larger and more expensive oscilloscopes can have more channels, sometimes even 5 or 6 channels available for drawing signals simultaneously. There's a right way and a wrong way of hooking signals up to the oscilloscope. The right way of connecting a signal to an oscilloscope is to ensure that the black wire coming out of the oscilloscope, or the grounding wire, corresponds to any ground that you might have in your circuit. The reason for this is that most oscilloscopes are grounded, meaning there is a cord or a wire in the back of the oscilloscope that's connected to the earth. That is internally connected to the black wire that you're seeing here. So if you were to hypothetically hook up your oscilloscope wrong, for example, by connecting the red wire to the ground and the black wire to your signal, then effectively you're grounding your circuit. This is the wrong way to do it. So to summarize, we want to make sure that it's the red wire that's connected up to the signal that you want to measure, and the black wire needs to be connected to ground. If your signal is floating, then of course it doesn't matter, but quite often your signal might be grounded somewhere. Let's assume that we've gotten our signal correctly connected up to our oscilloscope. Once it's connected and power has been turned on, a very important button to know about is the auto button. Sometimes it's called auto set. On modern oscilloscopes, this button will automatically try to find the signal and draw it with good proportions. So let's go ahead and press the auto set button. In this example, we're only using channel 1, and the oscilloscope has correctly detected that only channel 1 is active. DC coupling on an oscilloscope refers to the fact that DC voltages can be measured, not just AC voltages. For beginning users of an oscilloscope, I recommend that you use DC coupling. This ensures that the voltages displayed are equivalent to the voltages actually apparent on the circuit. If you use AC coupling instead, then it only shows that time-varying portion of the signal, and the oscilloscope won't show any DC offset. This can cause some voltages on the oscilloscope to not be matching with the actual voltages in a circuit. Again, I recommend that you use DC coupling. An important functionality of an oscilloscope is the trigger. What the trigger does is it allows a signal to overlap itself when the display refreshes. Sometimes signals that you put into an oscilloscope might move very quickly, so we want the oscilloscope to draw the signal overlapping itself every time the display is refreshed. There are a couple different trigger modes, and I'm going to show two of them right now. This oscilloscope is currently set to trigger on source 1, with a trigger mode of falling edge. What falling edge means is that the oscilloscope looks for a falling edge of the signal right where the trigger level, or this red line, cuts through the central vertical bar on this screen. So if you look right in the center of the screen, you can see that the red line and the white line cut through the signal where we have a falling edge. Let's change the setting to rising edge so you can see the difference. An oscilloscope set up for rising edge triggering will try to make sure that a rising edge of the signal overlaps itself every time the display refreshes. If we try to change the trigger level by rotating the knob labeled trigger level to any voltage higher than any part of the signal, then you'll normally wind up with a mess on the screen because it's highly unlikely that the oscilloscope will know where to draw the signal when it refreshes the display. If you see a mess like this on the screen, it's normally an indication that the trigger is not properly set. Many oscilloscopes also allow you to trigger using an externally provided signal. An oscilloscope has both horizontal and vertical display settings. Since the main job of an oscilloscope is to graph voltage versus time, it's possible to change the scale of the vertical and horizontal axes of the graph by rotating either the volts per division knob or the time per division knob in order to scale the graph properly. If you select AC coupling rather than DC coupling for a signal, it can be convenient for ensuring that AC signals are centered on the graph, but keep in mind that any DC offset will disappear. Another important setting found on many oscilloscopes is the stop or run button. Sometimes a signal might be changing very rapidly and you want to stop it in order to get some useful measurements from it. Just hit the stop button and then often a cursor will appear. You can move the cursor around or measure things like frequency and voltage once the signal has stopped. Let's go ahead and measure the circuit we have here on the bench using our first oscilloscope. Now, this circuit right here is floating. It's not connected to any earth ground, so it turns out that it doesn't matter which one of these cables gets connected to the signal and which one gets connected to the ground on the circuit. If this circuit had hypothetically been connected to an earth ground, I would want to make sure that the black wire here of the oscilloscope is also connected to that point of the circuit. Since the circuit here is floating, it doesn't matter. I'll be using channel 1 here on the oscilloscope. I've now connected the signal point of this circuit to our oscilloscope. As I mentioned, one of the most important buttons on an oscilloscope is the auto set button. On this particular model, it's labeled auto, so I'm going to go ahead and push the auto button and we'll let the oscilloscope choose its own display settings. As you can see from the drawing, the circuit here on the bench is a sine wave generator. We're going to be making some measurements of this sine wave, but before we do that, I want to show you what happens when I adjust the trigger knob. The horizontal line here represents the trigger level. Let's see what happens if the trigger line overshoots the signal. The oscilloscope is now having trouble drawing the signal on top of itself every time it refreshes. Let's fix the trigger settings, and now let's make some measurements of our signal here. I'll be measuring the peak-to-peak voltage and the frequency. Under the menu section of the oscilloscope, there's a button called Measure. I'm going to press Measure, and a little menu is going to pop up. There are two subcategories in this menu. One is called Voltage, and one is called Time. That's where we're going to find our measurements. So, firstly, choosing Voltage, we can scroll down to peak-to-peak and select that one. And then choosing time, we can scroll down to frequency and choose that. As I choose each of these settings, the measurement pops up here on the screen. We can see that the peak-to-peak voltage of this signal is 3.38 volts and the frequency is 885 hertz. If I change the scale here on the vertical settings, I can change how large the signal displays. It doesn't change the actual voltage, though. It just changes how the display is scaled. Likewise, with the horizontal settings, I can make the display stretch out horizontally, but it doesn't change the actual frequency of the signal. It just changes how it's displayed. I'm going to shut down this oscilloscope, and we're going to make the same set of measurements here on a slightly older oscilloscope. I've gone ahead and connected the signal here to oscilloscope number 2. Let's go ahead and turn it on. It looks like this older oscilloscope needs to run through a calibration procedure, so let's give it some time here to let it finish. The oscilloscope says press any key to continue, so I'll press some random key. Let's hit auto set on this oscilloscope. Looks like this oscilloscope was able to find the signal. Now let's find the peak-to-peak voltage and the frequency of this signal. There's a button here called Measure, and it looks like Measure has brought up a menu. I'm going to hit the first blue button here. Peak-to-peak is 3.36 volts. On this oscilloscope, you can cycle through all the measurements just by hitting the button repeatedly. So let's go down here to the second button. Peak-to-peak voltage, RMS voltage, mean voltage, 0 volts, it's an AC signal. Frequency, 880 hertz. And although this oscilloscope took a little bit more time to boot up, it's able to give us the same information as the newer one. Now, I'm going to turn this oscilloscope off, and let's take the same measurements on this older oscilloscope down here. We've now gotten our oscilloscope connected up to our circuit here. Let's turn it on. This particular oscilloscope is from the 1990s, so it has a very interesting screen here. Let's go ahead and hit auto scale. We can see that this oscilloscope works very much like the others. Here there are some buttons under measure that are important for what we need to do. One of the buttons is called voltage and the other time. Let's hit the voltage button and we can see a menu pop up, and one of the measurements is peak-to-peak voltage. Let's hit this button. We have found that the peak-to-peak voltage is 3.359 volts. Let's hit the time button, and there we see frequency. Let's hit that button. We now see that the frequency is 885 hertz. Although these three oscilloscopes here have been manufactured decades apart from one another, they're all able to take the same basic measurements of our signals. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.